Hey everyone, welcome to STCPod, episode number 233. A little brief intro to this one. This podcast was recorded over two separate days.
Why does your voice go up so high when you're trying to be nice on the microphone?
I'm always nice.
Do you forget what show this is?
The first half was recorded yesterday, that being Tuesday of this week, and it was a very angry record. A lot of stuff was not going right. And it was cut abruptly short, but you'll find out why. You'll have to listen to the end of yesterday's record, and then we'll jump back in and introduce today's record, which is done on Wednesday. So a two-parter amalgamated into one.
Do you want to do a pre-apology right now to the listeners for what they are about to hear?
I apologize for how Bill acted. Now on with the show.
Let's get this party started. I got my beautiful Joe on camera, and he is smiling. He's so happy.
Smile of frustration.
Oh, man.
You better find us. I'm fucking done. I'm done with Google. If you don't find us something new to use, I'm done with this stupid podcast.
I did find something.
Joke.
Piece of. That's got to be a first. We get that within 30 seconds.
I'm furious right now. This is not going to be.
Hello, everybody.
This isn't going to be a long podcast either. I'm done.
You know, that's not cool.
I don't care.
We got lots of good vibes, man.
I just joke, man. I had to reset my computer. First off, I'm so fucking tired. I accidentally, when I logged into Google Hangouts, asked me, do you want to trust this website? So I accidentally hit no, never. I didn't realize what I clicked on. So it kept asking me to install it for some reason again. So I did it three times. And every time I installed it, it installed fine and still wouldn't let me get into it. So I finally went to my security preferences and saw that I had blocked Hangouts. So I unblocked it. And then I got in and we were having audio issues where I couldn't hear you. So then I had to reboot my computer, which takes 15 minutes. Came back in, no audio. You unplug your mic, no audio. You reboot your computer and restart the session, audio. I'm done. I'm done with these dopey podcasts. No one gives a crap. I'm tired of wasting my time at nighttime.
Well, it looks like next week's podcast will be a solo Bill cast, I guess, guys.
I don't care. Find a new fucking host.
Big Baby got all upset. Oh, man. I didn't have to restart my computer. It was just, I did a new session.
Yeah.
Started
enough
a new
of Google. Enough of Google.
I have another program, but I lost the link to it. So I got to figure out what that was.
I'm done.
You mean you're starting a new program on My Life and Collecting? No,
I'm joking. I'm nuts. I'm starting on nothing. I'm done. I don't give a shit about any of this. I was in a good mood till this fucking Google got me cursing like a storm now. Great. Sorry, guys.
Yeah. Someone has, no issues there. No anger issues at all. No anger issues. You guys wonder why I was at the Barry Game Exchange with a black eye that I said I got when I accidentally walked into a door. Now, you know what happened. So there it is. Someone's got problems. He's got to get a hold of himself.
I just expect stuff to work when I do it. There shouldn't be issues. Sick and tired of computers. Google doing this, Google doing that. Apple giving me headaches.
What? But you did admit to you started this whole chain.
Done with everybody.
You started this whole chain. I'll just get that off. You admitted it.
Done. Done.
Done. Good show.
Yep.
Good show, everybody. Well, what's your big speech about positivity? How you want to be positive? Look at you.
Yeah, I'm all agitated, man.
What's going on? I was excited to chat with you, man. I missed you so much.
No, you don't.
Yeah. We've had 3 days away from each other.
And this is why it would have been a good night to do it. And then it starts off crap.
I think something got in your craw earlier on. What was going on this afternoon?
I just been a long day working outside too. Nothing but issues.
Issues.
Yes. Equipment issues outside. Technical issues.
Yeah, we know your issues. Issues all of us wish we could have. Don't forget, you're bringing me a piece of equipment tomorrow.
What? No, I don't have it tomorrow now.
I need it tomorrow. I got to get that shit done. I
didn't find it.
Here we go. Just like the shears.
You got to give me heads up, man.
I gave you a week heads up. I've been
working all day today.
Just go in your massive garage. It's buried and get it.
Under stuff. I can't. It's buried. I'll have to give it to you next week because you're taking your. I'm only seeing you one day this week.
No, I am booked in the entire week. Thank you. Pending any kind of difficulties that may arise.
So I won't. I'll have to give it to you next week. Sorry, man. It's buried. I don't even know where I buried the bloody thing.
We're talking about a pressure washer. So I just need, I got one job to do. I don't want to buy a pressure washer for one little deck clean.
No, I just use mine.
Well, I would like to, just like I wanted to use your garden shears that you couldn't find either. I had to buy my own set.
No, you didn't have to buy them. You could have done it with the hand clippers.
Not true. Would have taken forever.
It would have taken 10 minutes instead of the 1 minute that it took you to decapitate that bush in front of your house.
Yeah, I think I went a little too crazy on it.
Wrecked it.
I may have wrecked it. I may have wrecked it. My sister was over this weekend and I had her take a look at it.
B-Bush from the county?
Yeah, yeah. Well, she's the one that directed me last year to cut it back to allow it to grow fresh again, which I did last year. And then this spring, I hacked her down again to get another fresh start. And she said, "You cut it again? You're not supposed to do it two times in a row." Oh, great. Thanks for that too late advice. But I see some sprouts. I see some sprouts. So I think it might. It's just taken so long because the spring has been so cold and relentless. But we've had a couple days of sun, so things are happening. The pear tree is about to blossom. It's so exciting in the backyard.
Dude, I already had to cut my grass, man.
Oh, that is ridiculous.
Yeah.
That is.
I had to cut it. I got to have to cut it again by this weekend.
No one should have cut their grass yet. It is just trying to wake up.
Mine's awake.
That's crazy.
Mine's like a baby born with a full head of hair.
You know what's awake? Your insanity in your head.
You know why? Because I fertilized my grass early and I put down extra soil and seed early.
You're crazy, man.
It just blooms.
It blooms.
It's popping green. Thick and green. So yeah, I cut it already for the weekend because my son had his first communion on Sunday, so I wanted it to look nice.
Not just your son.
Your daughter too?
Yeah, and you know, it turns out like that's a worldwide day for it, eh?
I don't know.
Yeah, there was news of that happening all over the world that on last Sunday. That was first communion for freaking everybody. I didn't know it was coordinated like that.
Well, if you went to church enough, you would know.
Oh, they tell you that?
Yes.
Hey, I'm the guy that actually showed up for the first communion workshops and waste of times that they put us through.
My son went with that stuff with my mother-in-law.
Well, I don't have staff to look after that, so I had to deal with that. And it was I don't waste time.
I don't deal with that stuff.
It's ridiculous.
It's like when I got married and they wanted me to go in and take courses and stuff or talk to the priest a bunch of times. Right. Like, what's going on with this? Just marry me. So in the end, I never got married in the Catholic Church.
Right. That's right. I forgot about that. That's
right. Booyah, motherfuckers. I got married in Disney.
Yeah. Yeah. So you got the young lad all dressed up?
He is. They wanted him to wear a full suit.
Yeah.
I'm not buying a suit for my son for one occasion.
That's kind of what they do.
No, he already had a nice silk shirt. So we just dress pants and he had dress shoes on. He's golden, man.
Probably should add a jacket.
Probably kiss my ass.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I had to buy a beautiful dress for the kid that's going to be worn once.
I'll have to buy a dress for my daughter at that time. That's fine.
I'll give you a good deal on one.
I'm not going out and buying a suit jacket for my son that's going to wear it once.
Wow, that is shocking to me, especially the respect.
Tell me what to do.
The respect your people show towards the church. Like, you think, you'd be all over having the most decorated child there and having the most, the biggest lavish affair afterwards as well. If movies like
that. I just had my parents and her parents and two great grandparents and then my son's godparents, which are my sister and brother-in-law, come over and two of my nieces, and that was it. Small little affair.
That's still 35 people, so that's not bad.
But it wasn't until, what time is yours at? Mine was at 4 o'clock.
2:30.
Oh, that's way better.
But, man, they drug that ceremony out. Holy mackerel. That was at least 2 hours.
Well, mine was just a regular mass, but I could have done without one person there. Very pompous and serious. I don't know who she was, but whatever. Starting off the mass, tapping on the microphone. Attention, people. We have some announcements to get through, like regular mass announcements for some reason. And she was very serious and demanded everybody's attention. So I gave her none of mine.
You will not get my attention.
Yep.
Wow, you've been in a mood this month, man.
I immediately closed my eyes until she was done talking.
Did they have the kids up at their own pews, you know?
No, they were all together. No, the rows were all reserved per family.
Oh, well, why didn't they just put all the kids together?
Because the kids sit with the family.
No, they should all sit together. No,
they don't know what to do. Then they just play around.
No, not in this situation.
Yeah, they do. They're stupid.
Okay. Well, at ours, all the kids were up in their own reserved pews. And the teachers were present. Like, their teachers took time out of their weekends to help out.
That's who I didn't see, any teachers.
And they kept things organized. And, of course, the First Communion Committee or whatever are all there keeping things orderly, you know, the administrators or whatever. And, you know, during the sermon part, the priest came right down into the main aisle and kind of freestyled for a bit with the kids, which was pretty interesting.
Yeah, my guy does it, too. He's got an accent, though. I don't know. Mm-hmm. I don't know who he is. Or where he's from, but a little hard to understand.
Uh-huh.
I like his co-priest. He's a little nicer.
Mm. Anyways, it, they did the whole singing of everything again, and it, let's add 40 minutes to this thing.
Guys. Yeah.
We're singing everything.
We had a good singer though. There's a one female singer, and then there's the guy up in the balcony doing the organ. And she was good. She came up to the mic every time and sang. But she was a little too much into it. She smiled too much for me. So I wrote her off too.
Do you think there might be anything like that? It might be you in any of this? Or is it all just the other people?
It's probably the other people. It's
probably the other people. Now, it's too much singing, man. I don't care if it's Caruso up there. Enough's enough. Let's just read the stuff you got to read and let's move on. Bam, how you do? And then when they did the first communion, finally, the father insisted that they have the kids come up and kneel in front and one at a time do it. And so getting through all those kids with the kneeling and all of that, geez, that added some time.
Our kids didn't kneel.
No, that's, I don't get it. But it was, the place was packed. It was rocking. It was rammed full of people. My father came up for a visit, which was nice. And him and my sister came together for the ride. Had a nice visit with them. He thought it was way too long too. He said, "You're right about the singing. They sing everything." I said, "I know. What's with the singing?" I'm glad someone else got to witness it and experience what I was experiencing. And that was it. There was no drama or anything. After the mass, that was it. Kid got in the car and away we went. Then we went, where do you celebrate and bury after every big event? What's the place you got to go to?
You go back home and eat. Where'd you go?
Well, I don't have the Joe Palace. So where do you go?
Where do you go? I don't know. Denny's? What?
Where do you go in Barrie to celebrate a major event?
I don't
live
in Barrie. I don't know. The Keg?
Uncle? Uncle?
That means nothing to me, dude. What the fuck is Uncle?
This is one of my closest friends here who knows everything about me. Uncle. Uncle Bob.
Bob's?
Yeah, Uncle Bob's Buffet.
I've never been.
Oh my!
You've never invited me.
You know we go there all the time. So
yeah, I don't go though.
That's where we went. Didn't disappoint. It was good. It was actually really good. Nice thick steak coming off that barbecue too, which was a nice change from what is usually there. Had some, I had some chicken and waffles, fried chicken, put it on a waffle and poured some syrup over it. I said to myself, it's about time I try this. And try it, I did. Yeah.
Yeah, I don't like that. That's not how it should be eaten.
I don't think you've tried it, so you don't understand how the flavors.
I've never tried it. I can't try that.
You should try it.
I don't want syrup on chicken.
Just neither do I, but just try it to see how the flavors mingle.
No.
That's how we try things. It's like putting a slice of sharp cheddar on an apple pie. It doesn't seem right until you do it and you go, holy, what's going on in my mouth? It's all working in a.
No, this is not right. It's not how nature intended.
I know. Some things work though.
No. Just because you say it works doesn't mean it works. You like a lot of weird things. It's not normal. It's not what nature intended. Chicken should be by itself. Waffles should be in the morning.
Well, that could be, but there's no harm in trying things. Try I did. I'm no worse for wear. Although, geez, we ate like crazy. They were here for two nights, ate like mad those 2 days. Lots of eating. It's good stuff.
Mm-hmm. I've been eating cannelloni and lasagna leftovers these last 2 nights.
Stereotypes exist for a reason. So
I'll be bringing more for work tomorrow, too.
I would love some three fucking cannelloni? Days of that
goddamn shit.
Cannelloni? I'll eat that. You can have my leftover wings and fries.
No, they're no good now. I'm parched. I gotta drink something.
So was that catering you brought in? You ordered that all in?
Sister-in-law brought catering from some place in Burlington.
But it was all
what?
It was all Italian food?
Well, that's all it was. I don't know what. If you call lasagna and cannelloni Italian food, then I guess so. I don't know where it was from. My son chose a chocolate ice cream cake, which is garbage. Chocolate.
Can you please this Nobody week book yourself chocolate. Book yourself in for a massage this week, please? Something's got to be done. Something's got to be done with you. You're going off the deep end. Have you not been using your sleep mask? Is that the issue?
No, I've been having, I have, but I've been having these, my hip and lower back have been bothering me so bad all week that I'm sleeping in my bed and then my wife has bad enough sleep. So then I toss and turn. And then I end up moving to the spare bedroom because I don't want to bother her. And then I have crappy sleep and that was it. So I haven't had a decent sleep for like 3 nights.
That's surprising.
And then I wake up and my back is all jacked up and my hip hurts and it takes me like an hour to get going.
You know what you should do?
And then I didn't even go to the gym today because that hurt so much.
As I was going to say, irritated. You should spend more time at the gym.
Well, I might go tomorrow if I wake up.
Yeah.
If I wake up at 4:45.
Yeah, that'll make everyone who works with you so much better off if you spend.
I'd be there for 5 and do like an hour workout.
Oh, that'll make all of us in such a good predicament with you. I can't wait for that. But keep complaining about your sore hip now. It's a sore hip and a sore back.
Yes, my right hip, the bone grinds.
You should definitely get a specialist for that, a different specialist.
My lower back hurts for some reason.
That's because you're old. That happens, especially when you push yourself at the gym at your advanced age. Like, get real. Come on. Everyone's got to retire from the athletics after a while. Don't you think?
I'm not there yet, man. Not there yet.
You're not there yet. Even Michael Jordan retired after a while because it was too much.
It's like I got pinched something in my lower back on the right side.
Put a couple more plates on the pulley.
Yeah.
That'll help it out.
I just take some more steroids. That'll take care of everything, right?
How about before you shoot your next video, don't do 150 push-ups so you appear jacked in the video? How about that?
What are you referring to now?
Oh, I don't know.
Really?
I might have saw a video where a dude had his freaking bicep stretched across his chest for the entire video. Like, look at this, everybody. And he's pushed it up against his pectoral muscle in order to flatten it out.
Maybe you just saw me sitting sideways in my chair.
Oh, I didn't say it was you. I'd
get the business from somebody.
Did you have a video?
I did. Did someone put a Twitter picture up?
I don't know.
Of themselves posing, pushing their chest out with their guitar hanging on the back wall.
Posing. If you want to see posing, check out the video of the guy
in front of a big screen TV.
How many push-ups did you do before your video?
0 push-ups.
Oh, balls. You had the pump on. Anyone who knows what the pump looks like. You had it going.
I saw a big pump in your chest as you were pushing it out. And you had your tightest shirt on too, by the way. I know your shirts.
You know my shirts.
I know your shirts. That is not a shirt you normally wear.
No, you're absolutely right. I put that t-shirt on, that shirt on today, and I wore it out and stuff. I had to take the kids to the dentist. And I'm sitting there in the dentist office looking down at the shirt, and it's like all a single color, except there was like flecks of orange and stuff in it, in the pattern, or what I thought was the pattern. And I thought, these orange flecks are really weird, how they're very random throughout the material. It's kind of interesting. And I look closer, it's all stains all down the front of that shirt. It's like, what the heck? What am I wearing? So I think I was wearing it like cooking butter chicken or something, and it splattered all over me, and it somehow just went in the closet. And then I just wore it because I thought it was a nice shirt.
Why would you wear that shirt to take your daughter to get to the dentist?
I opened the closet door. I'm like, hey, short sleeves, sunny out. Let's go. I wore this shirt.
You've never worn that shirt to work once.
Yeah, I have. That was one of my favorite shirts. It's just forgotten. And there it was. I thought, well, I'm going to throw this on.
Well, it doesn't fit you anymore. Well, you know.
Actually, it fits me better than it ever has.
That shows everything.
It was much worse before. I promise you that. So, anyways, it's in the laundry. I don't know if it'll survive the laundry because those stains looked put in there.
Wear it around the house, man. Who cares?
No, it's not. It's, yeah, not a comfy shirt like that. No
one cares.
But, yeah, I had the kids in. I've been in dentist's office for weeks now, it seems, with these kids. Cavities on the big kid, and then the little kid, her teeth, her, like, baby teeth weren't falling out fast enough. You know what I mean? So the adult teeth are, like, growing all around it. And the dentist was, we gotta pull these teeth. It's the only thing. We got to get these out so the big teeth got room to come in. So booked another appointment for that. And that was today. And we thought it was going to be two teeth coming out. And he got her ready for the freezing and put the numbing gel on the gums. And he put a lot of that numbing gel on her gums, which I was quite happy with. And then he goes in with the needle. And he must have been probably close to 15 minutes putting the freezing in. He went through two vials of freezing into her gums and going super, super slow, like so delicately. It took that long, but she never felt in like a pinch at all. He's like, the second you feel anything, just raise your arm and we'll back off. And she never did. He kept being very surprised, like, are you okay? You're still okay, right? He's like, yeah. Pounded in two of those vials and then ended up, went for one tooth, went for another tooth. You know, what the hell, we're here. So he went for three, took out three teeth. And that third one was, that was in there good. He was pulling so hard, her head was wagging back and forth. I thought, oh my God, I hope he knows what he's doing and he's not pulling out an adult tooth here, because that thing is in there. He went and got a new set of pliers. Well, these pliers ain't doing it. Let's get a new pair. Gets a new pair in there, starts pulling back and forth. Finally, it comes out. And luckily, it was baby tooth. But,
dude, that's gross, man.
Yeah. It's gross. I had to watch it. And they get in there before pulling. They get in there with like this this tool to, like, you know, as if you were you know, clearing the sides of a cake from a cake pan, you know, along the sides with a knife. You get in there and kind of clear the edges first before you pull it out. He was doing that. Yeah, it was hard to watch, and then out it came. So she got
this is your little one?
Yeah.
Yeah, she's tough as nails, man.
Tough like her dad. Three teeth are out. That's costly tooth fairy night for sure. And
how much do you give? My son just pulled out. He lost two of his two front teeth all within the span of a week. And that was like a week ago. And the second one he pulled out himself.
Yeah, if they're brave like that and they're yanking
out themselves. Dude, I was never like that. I remember one visit or one tooth. I had to get my mom to take me to the dentist so he could pull it out. I was so disturbed at how loose it was in my mouth.
That's shocking. So that's your first instance of you going to a specialist for nothing.
But he's like, he was downstairs in the kitchen and then he goes upstairs and like literally 2 minutes later, he comes down with a Kleenex in his mouth. I pulled my tooth out. I'm like, what the fuck? Gross. Good for you, kid.
Yeah. That's a $5 tooth in my opinion.
So he's missing, he got a dollar. He's missing his two front teeth now.
Yeah, they're up to $5 a pop now.
Yeah.
With inflation.
We did 20 for the first tooth. And now it's like $1 or $2 every tooth, and that's it.
20? Holy Jesus.
It's a big one, man.
I'll hand you over some of my teeth. $20.
Yeah, well, it adds out after a while.
I remember when I was a kid. This was like the first bad dental experience I had, which turned me off dentists forever. I had to get a tooth pulled, but I was like in my teens, I think, like 13 or something. And this baby tooth just wouldn't go away kind of thing. And he froze me. But you know how I mentioned they do the numbing gel first so you don't feel the needle? He forgot to do the numbing gel. And he just goes in with the needle. And if you've ever felt that without the numbing gel, I still remember it's that you just, it is that it feels like they're tapping right into your bone and pushing as hard as they can with a sewing needle. And you can just feel everything.
I've only had one needle done. I don't remember them using a numbing gel though. And it didn't. I remember I was so worried about it because it's the one and only time I've had a needle in my mouth and there was no issues. I didn't feel it. It's like when I had,
they put the numbing gel in, you just didn't know it.
No, I didn't. I don't remember him putting gel in my mouth. I don't think they did back then.
Yeah, they did. You wouldn't have noticed.
No, my guy was old fashioned.
There's no way you would not know you had that needle in your gum. You maniac, especially you.
That's what I would have thought. I never had numbing gel. I'm telling you, man. Yeah, true story.
No.
Why not?
If you believe Joe, write in and support him, but I don't know. Someone should set up a poll. Because we know your pain threshold. We know this.
I've never seen a dentist use numbing gel.
So you've managed to stay away from cavities your entire life as well?
No, I had one cavity, but the one cavity I had filled in, it was so small, I just told them not to use a needle or anything, just go in and clean it out.
Oh, well, that's because it wasn't deep enough to get to the nerve.
But that wasn't the needle. That was...
Yeah, that's not you being a man. That's just it wasn't deep enough. If it was on the nerve, you wouldn't have manned your way through that if it was on a nerve.
No, he wouldn't have let me do it if it was on a nerve. But I'm saying when I got the needle, I remember what it was for. But he just put the needle in. I don't remember being numbed. I would have remembered that he had rubbed something on my gums. Because that would have freaked me out too, because I don't like gel and stuff being rubbed in my mouth. That's why I like my dentist now. He's just a nice little Chinese guy, super friendly. Reminds me of someone that we used to work with. He's great. Love him. Dr. Ko.
That's hilarious. Our dentist's name is Dr. Cho.
And the other dentist in the office is Dr. So.
Well, I don't know the name of the other dentist in there, but could be close to that.
He's great though. When we moved to Whitby, we're looking for a dentist and just arbitrarily picked this guy out of the blue for no reason and been happy with him since. So
I gotta say, this one is pretty good too, especially with the financial bits. He'll never charge you for what you're not covered. And right now, for some reason, my insurance did a little woo-woo and nothing went through. There was the coordination of benefits got screwed up or some stupid thing, and I had to deal with our benefit administrator, whoever that is, and get them on the phone and straighten this out and get that put through, and then that goes through the thing, and they're like, 2 weeks later it'll be straightened out, and they're like, you could just pay your dentist with your credit card or whatever and we'll reimburse you in 2 to 3, 4, 5 weeks. Like, oh, that sounds great. But you talk to the dentist people and they're like, ah, don't worry about it, we'll just put it through in a month, we'll just hold on to it, so don't worry about it. Yo, that's great, I like that. That's the way to do it.
I don't know how your dentist is, but they've got something with ours where my, I guess it's the receptionist's part of her job. She hounds you when it's your visit time. I get phone calls. I get emails. Because she'll call once and I brush them off, right? And say, oh, yeah. I don't know my schedule yet. I'll get back to you. And then my wife starts getting calls, and then I get calls again. And then when it comes time to close the appointment, I get emails reminding me about appointments where I have to confirm. And I get text messages from them that I have to type C back to confirm. They really want you to come in, man. I don't get it. Oh, my God. Bill's frozen again. Mother. Freaking Google, man. Not getting angry. You're frozen again. Try to rejoin the Hangout. I am so done with Google. Let me tell you. Where is this Bill's internet? And someone's using a microwave. Well, short record, guys. Sorry about that. Make a little note here. Bill's frozen. Internet again. Okay, he's out. Waiting for people to join this video call. This is ridiculous. Maybe if someone can recommend something that we can use to record with a little less headaches. Oh, man. This is ridiculous. Oh, here he is.
What happened?
Hello? Can't hear you now. Great. Mother trucker. Yeah. You just type, okay, just end this, I guess. All right, guys. I don't know who's talking, or I guess Bill can hear me. I can't hear him.
If you
thanks can again hear for tuning me, in,
listeners.
Another Hangout. Check out Bill on Twitter at STCPod and find me at AC Decepticon.
Yeah, I want to say sorry, and we'll catch you next time. Don't know what happened. Connection drop. I don't know if that was me or if that was Joe, but...
And Bill said something. I don't know what he said.
We'll catch you so next just week.
Go with it. Wrap her up.
Shit it and shit on it. All right. So, yeah, we're back with the fresh next day recording. Fresh look at that that old recording. Whew, that was a roller coaster. Man, I got beat up there. Had my teeth knocked out. I'm still smiling. I'm back here. I'm back. On the bus, on the STC pod bus. I'm under the wheels, but I'm still there. I'm hanging on.
How can Joe's you be on us. It if you're under the bus?
I don't know. I don't know. Joe's in a much better mood today, as he should be, because everything comes up golden for Joe, let me tell you. I got to witness his meals today, and he had 4 separate containers of hand-baked, homemade Italian dishes that were extraordinary, from cannellonis, lasagnas, pastas. What do you call that? The tubular pasta you like? What is that?
That's the penne pasta.
Penne. And what did I eat? I had some of your chicken.
You took half of my chicken parmesan, whatever you want to call it. I don't know.
Yeah. It was glorious too. I like how they didn't go heavy on the cheese, you know? It was a cheesy kind of red sauce.
It was a cheesy sauce, yeah.
Yeah. I really enjoyed it. So I appreciate
I appreciate everybody sticking around after Bill's roid rage he had in the first half of the podcast. He bugs me about going to the gym, but the amount of roids this guy takes, for what reason, I have no idea, but he's got to vent it somewhere.
Seriously, if we were to, you know, line up who should be the one going crazy with anger, I should be just going crazy every day, but I'm level-headed and straight and narrow, and but I'm the guy with the luck. I got the luck, let me tell you. I got up today. You know this. We talked about this already. First thing I had to tell you this story. Got up today, you know, 4 a.m. to go to work. Jump in the old shower. And, well, I turned the shower on. And then I like to throw on, like, Stern or something on the radio while I'm showering and getting that all ready. Then I stick my hand in the shower, make sure it's not too hot. Not too hot. It's ice cold. What in the hell? Ice cold. So I crank it. Sometimes with my hot water system, like if I don't have like a shower for a couple days or something, it kind of like goes to sleep or something. And you really got to crank the heat to get it to come out. I don't know what the heat is settling or something. I don't know. And I thought that's just what the deal was. So I cranked it all the way. I could just barely get the sense of like warmth out of it. And it was going to be cold, but I had no choice because I didn't have a shower the day before. My hair was all greased back. Yeah. Cold shower time. Kramer says it's the best thing for your health. So I'm jumping in and woof. That was not fun. Wash the hair with cold water. Wash the body with cold water. I get out and go, you know what? This ain't right. This only means one thing. So I get myself all dressed and whatever and head downstairs to the basement and open up the door to the furnace room and look in the corner where the hot water tank is. And yeah, there's a good almost an inch of water on the floor down there. So the hot water tank just decided to let go that night for some reason. The day after my company went away, maybe, you know, my sister was, that was her bed down here in the basement. Maybe she was tinkering with stuff in the middle of the night, banging away at the hot water tank or something, a little sabotage. I don't know, but the hot water tank let go. So
is this the sister that likes me?
That likes you? Well,
is this a B bottom one?
Yeah. And so I had no time. Like I'm due to work in an hour. It's not like I can call in and just cancel at this point. I'm just too important for that. The place would burn to the ground. So I'm like, I don't know what to do. I don't know what to do. So I just kind of threw some towels down, sop up what I could. I turned off the water to the tank. I didn't hear any more leaking going on. There's no more dripping. So I was confident it had stopped. It wasn't to the point where it was climbing up the drywall or anything like that, luckily enough. And it is right beside the sump pump hole. So maybe most of it already went down there, but I said, screw it. Threw some towels down there, old sheets and blankets, whatever. I'll deal with this when I come back. And went off to work. Then I saw you first thing, told you a story. No sympathy. No sympathy from the guy.
You walked into the cafeteria about 6:30, found me playing my Vita in one of the armchairs, handed me my coffee and proceeded to tell me your sob story.
Yeah, I handed you your coffee. That's right. I still got you a coffee. Even though I was running late because I spent that extra time fiddling about in the basement. Yeah. So then I called the hot water tank people today because I rent a hot water heater. I don't know if that's, is that a common thing in North America to rent?
So. We still rent one.
Yeah, that's pretty, like, I think everyone here does that for some reason. I mean, you could buy a hot water tank heater for $1,000 and then you're done with it, but then you have to worry about the installation and all this jazz and the warranty. If you rent it, yeah, you're paying, I think I pay $20 a month, but you have all this maintenance covered and all that, installations covered. Anyways, I call them up and tell them this happened, and they're like, okay, we can help you. And I give them my name and my number and my address and my account number and my special passwords and say the alphabet backwards and all that. And they're okay, I'll be right back with you and we'll get this going. And I go on hold and it rings to another number and another operator picks up the phone and says, how you doing? This is the water tank people. Well, how can I help you? I'm like, well, hot water tank let go. We need a replacement. Okay, sir. Can I get your name and your number and your social insurance number? And I'm like, we just did that. I just did this with a guy. Why are we doing this again with another person? Oh, you know, that you can't never tell where this gets transferred from. Like, yes. I don't get this. Why are we doing this again? Anyways, I have to go through the whole thing again, give them all my information and birth certificate and, you know, all kinds of things, passports, everything. And anyways, the next day I'll be getting tomorrow, I'll be getting a brand new water heater installed. I was thinking about going tankless, but that's like double the rental price. And it's not like it's that much of a convenience factor, at least for me, because the hot water tank is away in the furnace room. It's not like I need extra space in there. So new tank coming. That's exciting. That's what you want to do on your days off. Except hot water tanks and people coming. Not to mention our record last night that got cacked due to my internet. So that's still happening, right? That was my connection that dropped.
Well, I think you just want attention. And that's why you keep on fiddling with your internet somehow.
Is that how I'm trying to get friends to come over?
I think so.
Meet new people? You'd think these internet people would be like my kind of people, that we'd have a good time, but I don't know. They don't seem to like me.
This Hershey chocolate bar right now.
Oh, why not?
Special dark. Is dark chocolate good? You ever have this one?
No. Special dark. No, I don't know what that is.
So they're coming tomorrow. So when you came home from work today, was there still like lots of water on the ground?
No, it was not too bad. And I had the big kid after school. She had to run down there and kind of swap out the wet towels for throw in some new ones and try to sop things up. And like I said, thankfully, it's not like you're seeing the water stains go up the drywall. It didn't get to be that kind of a situation. It was all contained in the furnace room, which is, it's just a cement floor. And I got like remnants of like linoleum remnants and leftover carpet pieces in there, you know, nothing to worry about. So
that's good. You know,
Just a headache. And then, you know, I yell at the big kid, get those clothes in the washing machine and get them washed and get them out of the way. Then you got to stop her 10 minutes later. Wait, you can't use the washing machine. It might use warm water. Don't use the washing machine. Then I yelled at the little kid, why aren't you in the bath yet? Get in the bath. Don't get in the bath. Stop what you're doing. Get back here. So there's a lot of that. But I have an excuse not to have a shower tomorrow. So that's pretty fun. I like that. Although this is one of these companies that gives you the giant time bracket that you can't go anywhere. So between 8 and noon, I have to be present 100%. And I was like, whoa, I, you know, I have to like take a kid to school. I'll be gone for like 15 minutes. Is that acceptable? Yeah, that should be okay. They'll call before they arrive. It's like, why are these big windows? To say I'll be here at 8:45. Why is that so hard? Not to mention, my car now is not just chirping at me that I'm due for service. It's chirping at me how overdue I am. It's currently saying you're 83 kilometers overdue from service.
I told you about that, man. Why are you not booking an appointment?
I like to go in to the quick change lane at the dealership and get it done that way, same day. But these dummies have changed the priority of the quick lube lane into tire changeover. So it's lined up all day long. People drop off their car in the morning and then pick it up at night, getting tire change bullshit done. And us guys who need maintenance are screwed. Oh, book an appointment. You can get it in 3 weeks. Ah, screw you.
Why didn't you book the appointment before?
Because I don't book appointments. I use the quick lube lane. That's why it's invented.
That's why you're still waiting. You can't use the quick lube lane at this time of season where you live.
That should not be an issue. You don't put the tire change dummies in that lane.
They have to, apparently, if they're so backed up.
God damn it. You're blocking actual maintenance for stupid tire changes.
Book an appointment 3 weeks ago.
No. Screw them. Those pricks. Pisses me off every time. This is my one time a year. I need an oil change. It's always that tire change.
Then you should know to
book it. I always get screwed.
Then you should know to book it. Even if it's early, book it.
I'm teaching them a lesson.
I always book my appointment even before I'm due.
I'm so frustrated. I'm thinking of just buying a new car rather than getting an oil change. That'll show them.
I had your money.
God damn it.
So you got your vacation approved for C3 in Chicago this year?
Yes.
So that's exciting.
Ready to go.
I still have not.
Which is an infraction in our labor agreement. So that was something you were supposed to bring up to the boss, and you did not. You just asked him how his breakfast was. They scrambled those eggs. Good, boss.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's what I said.
Yeah, that's some good scrambling there, eh? They really know their bacon. How about talk about your days off, Joe? Nope. You're getting big with confronting me. How come you don't confront anyone else? That's what I don't
confront. Well, because you deserve to be confronted, though.
I deserve it. Yeah. I'm always looking after you, pal. Let me tell you.
And if you listen to me, you'd be better off in so many ways.
You know, the other thing that's going on, speaking of cars, is have you heard this? They're finally talking about raising the speed limit on our major highways.
Yeah, I don't like that.
Oh, I'm totally agreeing with
that. And they're also talking about giving infractions if you're driving too slow in the fast lane.
Oh, my. 100%. I think they should be blown off the road with bazookas.
Minimum speed limit is 100. You can drive 100. In the fast lane, legally.
If
you shouldn't be getting a ticket for going 100 in the fast lane.
I cannot even believe you would defend this practice. If you are impeding someone, you're in the wrong. If you are being passed in the right lane.
The speed limit is 100.
If someone's passing you on the right side, that is an indication you're in the wrong spot.
Legally, the speed limit is 100 maximum. Correct? Yes or no?
Yes or no? I think you're talking psychotically now.
What do the speed signs say? What's the maximum speed limit?
100.
Thank you.
This is the same as all those asshole middle lane lurkers that drive me fucking bonkers. Go in the right lane. If you need to move over to allow someone onto the highway or to pass, then get in the middle lane. It's easy as that. It's so frustrating. You know, you can look up the right lane and it is completely wide open and I'm passing everyone on the right, which I'm not supposed to do, but all these people are so afraid to be in the right lane because they may have to,
who's afraid?
The people are afraid to be in the right lane because they're afraid of merging traffic. And you know,
that's people that just don't know how to drive.
Well, it's partly their fault and partly the fault of people who don't know how to merge onto highways as well, because some people just go without finding a hole. And that makes the timid middle lane lurker panic. So they'd say, oh, I'm going to cruise in the middle lane and screw everyone else.
I think 120 is perfectly fine and shouldn't be higher.
Oh, well, okay.
They're going to raise the minimum speed to 120.
Good.
Which means that the max people can drive is going to be 140 now.
Now, right? here's my solution. Will you hear me out?
Depends.
And, you know, privately, I've talked to many leaders of the community about this. And finally, I'm going to let everyone else know the perfect solution to this problem. Here it is. I agree. The new limit is 120. Now, most people get a little scared with that because, as you say, if you raise the limit to 120, that means people think it'll be fine to go 140, 145. The limit's now 120, and you put photo radar back on the streets, but you tell everyone what photo radar is set at, and you have it automated on every single overpass at 130. If you're going more than 130, you're getting a ticket in the mail automatically, but the limit is 120. Photo radar set at 130. No secrets, nothing to hide. We're telling you the photo radar's out there, and that's what it said.
I never understood that when we used to have the photo radar vans.
Right.
And people had to be told where they were.
Well, because they were pricks with it. Like,
no. You don't have to tell people shit.
No, they were pricks with the van because they had no buffer. They would set the limit on the van at 105. So, like, even if you pulled around to pass someone doing 98, you would ultimately trickle over 105, get around 107, and you'd get a ticket. And that drove people fucking crazy. But if you make a nice compromise and say you got till 130, no secrets here. The limit is 120. We understand how sometimes you might creep over 120. You'll get a ticket at 130. Just be completely open with everyone and automate it. Have it everywhere. Like have 200.
That's not going to happen. They're not going to spend money on photo radar.
Well, I think it's an easy solution and it'll bring in money.
They're not going to spend the money on it.
And it will calm down the highways. Like it's just so easy a solution. So easy. Thank you. Elect me president. Exactly.
What you said is not going to happen. So who would elect you?
People who like common sense. That's perfect common sense solution. It's thank you very much. I'll even let our elected leaders steal that idea from
us. Listen, I can run with it. I can say whatever sensible things that need to be said to make people happy. It doesn't mean that they're going to happen because of the financial restrictions.
Well, that's the only thing that I would say I don't want the speed limit raised, because that puts it in the minds of dummies. They can go way, way past that.
And then where's the cutoff where you get your car impounded? Because now it's, if you go 150 and you get tagged, your car immediately gets impounded. Your license gets suspended for 30 days. And your car has not only been impounded, but a chance of being destroyed, right? Crushed in the car compactor, whatever they call it, right?
Really? That's on the table?
Yeah.
I never heard of that.
If you're going 150 plus, they've got the right to destroy your vehicle.
I've never heard of that. If that's true, I totally applaud that. And I don't think they should move it from 150 because anything over 130 is getting crazy. It's still crazy town up at 150 when other people are trying to travel that road. So
I think they should raise it to 110. But I don't care if they don't raise it. I'm perfectly happy with how things are. It's fine.
You don't drive on the highway.
I drive on the highway every day.
Nah, that's nothing.
Why?
That's nothing.
Because I chose not to live in the bush and drive an hour and a half.
Just follow my what I laid out.
No, that's perfect. You do what I do, and you'll be good.
I currently drive my cruise control is always set at 114.
I don't need cruise control.
You're part of the problem. No, you're that guy who I have to pass, and then I'm on cruise control, and there's Joe passing me again. What? And then yeah, I stay I'm on passed, cruise control.
Right. I'm passing you.
And then
he
slowed
you.
Down again. And then, oh, I got to pass this guy again. Pass no, him.
You're
and
the
then,
guy
oh, he's passing
get,
me again.
No, you need to get out of my way with your 114 garbage.
No, you fucks who don't use the cruise control because you're crazy.
I don't
crazy,
need to.
You I've don't know how to regulate your speed. That's the problem, too.
My speed does not vary.
When I could I, run these people is, off the road.
No, my foot is a cruise control up your
they
ass.
They drive me crazy. They make me put my brakes on, and then they speed up because they realize they've been dozing. And then they speed up, then they slow down, then they speed up. Like, get off the road. You're on a modern vehicle. Use cruise control. It's better on
There's
gas.
There's no need for cruise control. If
it's
you know
better
how to
for gas.
Regulate with your foot. Subtle you touches are way more intuitive than just leaving it in stupid cruise control. That's for dummies.
No, no.
That's okay. For lazies.
That is not for lazies. That's better gas mileage
and
for
you
one.
Know, you know, listen, you know what our highways are like. There's no room for fucking cruise control on the highways. So
because
stop
of you
go.
Guys.
No, that's because
right,
of you
guys.
Because you're stupid because cruise control because you don't know how to drive. Go to driving school.
No.
Learn how to drive without cruise control.
I wish the world was on cruise control. Get everyone
I wish
on cruise
you were
control.
Off of it. Stop being lazy like everything
it's,
else.
It's not being lazy. It's being efficient. It is the no. most efficient way to drive.
It's being lazy.
And that way, the entire, if you can imagine, all of the flow of that highway, all running at the right speed, that's what they were thinking
Guess
when
what?
They invented highways.
It's the real world.
That's what they were thinking.
Happen. That hasn't happened in 500 years.
Obviously, in your little built-up area where you can't cruise control, yeah, you have a point. But on a major highway
Dude,
going 100
on
kilometers.
Which is the worst highway in all of North America.
There's no reason why everyone can't be on cruise control on that highway.
Can't happen.
One
can't
flash.
Happen.
One flash of brakes causes a ripple effect
Here we
that
go.
Is seen
it goes
miles
back
down
14
the road.
Miles. It's called the butterfly effect. I saw that in a Tom Cruise movie.
Yeah, that's right.
The writers put that line, about one line in there to make him seem like a super intelligent person.
Just get on cruise control because you
just
can't
learn
regulate.
Drive. Learn how to Some, drive like a real man.
Someone like you who refuses to use the button on his phone, just think of it that maybe you shouldn't use your accelerator because you're going to break it. So just hit the cruise control button so you don't have to worry about it.
I'm perfectly in tune with my car with my foot. Just like my fingers on a certain body part. Right, ladies?
Well,
all right, let's wrap this one up.
I think we gave everyone a big old bonus today. A bonus.
Let's wrap it up because I'm starting to get angry again. Your cruise control bullshit.
That was a nice chat. I won.
No, you didn't. You just showed everybody you don't know how to drive.
You should go get your cruise control fixed so it works.
You should go to driving school so you know how to drive with the actual pedal.
So be sure to tune in every Friday for your Start to Continue podcast starring Joe and Bill, or more commonly known as Bill and Joe. and tune on over to our YouTube channel, Start to Continue, where you'll see a pickup video and maybe something special will come out.
Nope.
Cause something
do your own like, shit
actually got edited. There's some effort involved, good quality audio. And I was just doing what Joe told me to do. He told me to go do that. Well, and I did it.
I'm telling everybody to go over to My Life in Collecting on YouTube and check out my latest video, which is my big box PC collection.
Your big bicep? Is that what you said?
Big box.
Your big bicep?
Yeah. I really just made the video to say big box a whole bunch of times.
If you want to see
I love big boxes.
You know what? Just tune into the special thing I'm talking about. There's no point in me railing about it right now.
It's going up. Told you.
I can't help what happens.
No, I can't. Well, I can't help you find another host for this podcast. So.
There it is. The ultimatum. I'm just doing what you told me to do.
No, I told you to make your own videos. I didn't say to go do.
You told me
to do reaction videos. Listen, even Musty doesn't want you to do it. Okay.
Musty's a gentleman. There's no gentlemanliness left on this channel. What are you anyways, talking about? Don't forget to go over to stcpod.com. Click on those Amazon links. Buy some stuff so we can get some commissiones.
Buy some. Yeah, whatever you want to buy.
People are forgetting. I know people are shopping in Amazon. They're forgetting our link. Come on. It's just an extra step. And we get you the good stuff. We get extra good deals there. We worked out a big contract with Amazon. We're one of their major partners. And what else? Follow me on Twitter at STCPod. And follow Joe at AC Decepticon. Is that it? No other announcements?
No, I think that's it.
Oh, we teased at C3, C3, Philadelphia, June 20 something. Be there, be square. Yeah, we're looking for people to show up there. Cartridge Club Convention, as well as Too Many Games. I guess we got to buy our ticket now for Too Many Games. We haven't done that yet. Right?
Do they sell out?
Oh, I hope not. Now, we'll sneak in. Musty will sneak us in. You know what? We could be dress up like Q-Dog children. Just go in that way. Mm. We'll walk in on our knees.
I think their kids are bigger than they are.
All right. Is that all you got?
Good finish. Way to kill it. Wrap it up.
Posting.